Tonight, a new tax on the city of Troy. Find out what it's for.
Plus, a major change in the Student Government Association. Stay tuned. Trojan Vision Nightly News starts now.
From the worldwide campuses of Troy University, this is Troy Trojan Vision Nightly News.
Hello and welcome to Trojan Vision Nightly News for January 13th, 2010. I'm Amber Carter.
And I'm Jessica Bozeman. Thank you for joining us this evening. For over a year, the fate of the hospital in Troy has been in question. Last night, the Troy City Council gave citizens the answer. And as Derek James tells us, Troy residents will help foot the bill.
Tuesday night, it was announced at the city council meeting that the city of Troy is going to buy Troy Regional Medical Center. Mayor Jimmy Lunsford tells us it is a good hospital, but it was just having problems with funding and needed the city's help.
We have a great hospital. The only problem the previous owners had was they had money problems. They got in undercapitalized and couldn't make the capital improvements and substantiate the bad debt, the write-offs that you have in the hospital industry now, throughout the country. Theirs was strictly a financial situation.
With the city taking over the hospital, many may wonder how that would affect the citizens and how the health service may change. But City Council President John Witherton says it should run just as it did before.
Well, it should be a seamless transition in that the hospital will not close. Same doctors will be there and the support staff, the nurses. And so the citizens of Troy shouldn't notice any change at all as far as the operation of the hospital. It'll just be under new owners.
However, there is one difference that the taxpayers will feel, and that is an increase of the general sales tax by 1%. Residents will not pay 9 cents on the dollar to help fund the hospital until the city decides which direction they will take in the future.
Well, the citizens of Troy will, at least on the short term, have to provide the necessary operating funds in order to operate their hospital. It's their hospital, and we want to have a first-class hospital. We've got a good one now, but the taxpayer is going to have to step forward, until we can get it on its feet and operating on its own.
The sales tax will be in place for 1 year. After that, Troy citizens will be able to decide in a referendum whether to keep the tax in place. Derrica James, Trojan Vision News.
The city will assume ownership of the hospital this Friday. The sales tax increase will go into effect in March.
The Student Government Association held its first meeting of the semester last night, and Mackenzie Hicks was there for a big announcement that was made.
I stand before you today to inform you of my resignation as Student Government Association President.
The resignation of Student Government Association President Jonathan Davis was the major topic of Tuesday night's meeting. Davis says this is something he had been thinking about for a while, and over the Christmas break, he made his final decision.
There are so many responsibilities that I have as an individual that I have neglected, actually, for a while. And it's very crucial that I do give attention to those things, responsibilities that I have beyond Troy.
With Davis stepping down, Vice President of Legislative Affairs William Fillmore will step in as the new president, and he says he's excited but hates to see Davis leave.
Well, it's an exciting thing at an unexciting time. I hate to see someone who's put as much work as Jonathan has having to resign and give up what he's worked so hard for since he started college.
Fillmore has had some time to think about what he wants to do as president and already has some ideas that he thinks will improve the SGA.
I would like to see our Senate meet in the Trojan Center, in the Student Center, because we are for the student body. We're elected to represent the members of the student body, and I think that would be a great thing.
Davis hopes that he is starting off 2010 right, but says he does have one regret about stepping down.
I have a regret to not maintain my focus. Of course, when you do get into different organizations, those can definitely pull your focus in different directions, but ultimately, I have no regrets other than for me to remain focused.
Both Davis and Fillmore have been in the SGA since they were freshmen, and if Davis had continued as SGA president, He would have only served for 3 more months before handing over the reins. Mackenzie Hicks, Troy Trojan Vision News.
Fillmore will be sworn in as the new SGA president at next Tuesday's meeting. Troy University's annual African American Leadership Conference kicks off at the beginning of next month, and this year the conference will feature a pair of nationally known speakers. This year's keynote speakers will be actor Tim Reed and former CNN news anchor Lynn Vaughn. Reed is probably best known for his roles on hit television series such as Sister Sister, Frank's Place, and WKRP in Cincinnati. Vaughn anchored CNN's headline news for more than 13 years. Registration for the conference is $30. For more information about how to register, you can contact Troy's Institute for Leadership Development at 334-670-5686. The deadline to register is January 25th. This year's conference is set for February 5th through 6th on the Troy campus. And now, taking a look at news from around the state, a judge has sentenced an Alabama man to 10 years in prison after he pleaded guilty to sexually assaulting a 13-year-old girl who ran away from her home in South Georgia. Houston County Circuit Judge Butch Benford imposed the sentence Tuesday on the 24-year-old William Chad Dean of Ashford. He pleaded guilty to multiple charges, including second-degree rape and sodomy. And next in state news, an effort by Democrats to use $1 billion over 10 years from a state savings account to build and repair roads and bridges across the state has gotten off to a quick start. The proposed constitutional amendment was approved Tuesday by a Senate panel. It now goes to the full Senate for debate. And last in state news, the Alabama legislature has taken the first step toward banning drivers from sending or writing a text message while operating a vehicle on a public road. The House Public Safety Committee approved a bill Wednesday that would fine a driver $25 for the first conviction for texting while driving. A driver would be fined $50 for a second conviction and $75 for each subsequent violation.